Unless you've been sleeping under a rock for the past week, the chances are you'll have heard about the recent sentencing of Bhavesh Patel, a British man who was caught letting his wife's Tesla Model S drive along the M1 motorway with nobody in the driver's seat while he stretched out in the passenger seat next to it. Aside from being illegal under UK law, the driver is required to have their hands on the wheel at all times while their car is in motion. The act was one of great risk, since Patel was treating the Model S and its autopilot driver assistance feature as a full level 5 autonomous vehicle, which it isn't. For that, Patel, who pled guilty at his hearing, was sentenced to 100 hours of unpaid community service, fined £1,800 in court costs, that's about $2,500, and banned from driving for 18 months. While Patel admitted in court that his actions were silly, he also told the court that his wife's Model S was capable of something amazing, adding that he was the unlucky one that got caught. Judging by some of the videos that have been floating around on the internet since Tesla switched on autopilot functionality several years ago, this comment does at least seem to hold some truth. But that's not the point. If you've watched this channel for any length of time, you'll know that personally, I'm very eager to see autonomous vehicle technology reach mainstream mass adoption due to all the benefits that fully autonomous cars can bring. But you'll also know that I'm someone who's very cautious of over-reliance on semi-autonomous advanced driver assistance systems like Tesla's Autopilot and Nissan's ProPilot, as they are not yet capable of the full level 5 hands-off operation that many think they are. In previous videos, I've explored who's to blame when semi-autonomous vehicle technology results in a death or an accident. I've also explored some of the legislative challenges that exist to bringing fully autonomous vehicles to market and called for drivers, automakers, and legislators to all work together to better build a framework on which official autonomous vehicle rules and operational guides can be hung. But after the cautionary tale of Mr. Patel, and having talked to many of you who've contacted me to tell me how advanced driver assistance systems have actually helped protect you and keep you safe, I'm wondering if we're all barking up the wrong tree. Instead of restricting advanced driver assistance systems completely, could we do something a little more targeted to seek out and punish what I'm going to call autopilot abusers, people who try to use autopilot and other advanced driver assistance systems for things that they simply aren't yet ready to be used for or aren't designed to do? After all, we don't punish people for having their cell phone in the car with them or even using an approved hands-free system to make a telephone call. No, we, society at least, punish people who use their cell phones in ways that are not deemed safe by attaching hefty fines and/or carrying out special crackdown campaigns. Given that active semi-autonomous systems like Autopilot and ProPilot tend to be pretty easy to spot from outside the vehicle because of the vehicle lane placement along with other cues, it should be easy for law enforcement to spot cars being used with autopilot-like systems, and a quick glance inside, as they would for a cell phone check, would generally be enough to tell if the driver is paying attention or not. But perhaps a better way to police appropriate use of these systems is actually to utilize the very same in-car technology that makes these systems possible. One option, of course, is to look and see if the driver is paying attention by using retinal tracking. This is something that Cadillac already uses in its Super Cruise driver assistance package, and the Tesla Model 3 does actually have a camera in its rearview mirror that faces towards the driver. While it's not used yet, it's a sign that perhaps Tesla is contemplating such an option in the future. Yet perhaps the simplest option is to use the hand detection feature already active on all lane keep and autopilot-like cars. Most cars beep to get your attention if you don't keep your hands on the wheel, and some, like Autopilot and ProPilot, will actually bring the car to a complete stop if you ignore the warnings and don't put your hands back on the wheel. Tesla will even lock out autopilot functionality until the car is restarted if you trigger the warning system too many times. And this is where my idea comes in. For example, it would be very easy, given modern car design, for automakers to track how many times hands-off warnings had been triggered over the lifetime of the car and the current trip. Trigger it too much, as you would do if you were abusing the feature, and the car would lock you out of all autopilot-like operation, forcing you to drive manually. And if you're worried that that could affect safety, you could always keep semi-autonomous braking and steering systems passively operating to protect the car and its occupants in a genuine accident scenario. But the rest of the time, abuse the system, don't follow the rules, and you'll find that the functionality gets turned off. After all, if you're going to have to pay a fine to switch it back on, aka reprogramming fee, wouldn't you use it appropriately to begin with? Would such a system work? Would it allow those who use semi-autonomous features properly to use them without punishment or consequence, while punishing those who abuse them? Or would it just be too difficult to track? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. That's it. Thanks for joining me, and see you next time.